Have a bluegrass Christmas. We're gonna sing a few good old songs. Hear the banjo ring while the Osbournes sing. Mac's gonna sing along. I can hear Del clear as a bell. I know you don't want to miss this. Listen to Doc on the old flat top. We're gonna have a bluegrass Christmas.
Well, it's been a little while since I've seen that little snowflake show up on the car's dash. Really, that little snowflake is unnecessary because, trust me, I know that it's cold. I don't need a snowflake to remind me. But I am thankful that I've got the heated seats on, I've got the heat on, the fingerless mitts, and I'm off to do some Good Samaritan work at Grandma's. The astute among us will notice that I have a check engine light on, but no worries. Hubby ran the codes, and it's just because I have a leaky gas cap. So anyway, let's get this day started. Okay, so it's Monday, the 7th of December, 2020. Vlogmas day 7, and it's beautifully bright outside. The morning started off, as you will have seen already, very cold, and it was gray for most of the day, but it's still very cold. It's let's see, I turned my Wi-Fi off to conserve my battery power. I think it was around 41 degrees was our forecasted high today anyway, so crazy cold. But at least it's nice and sunny, so that warms me up just looking out and seeing that bright sun. I am currently awaiting notice about my grandmother's cardiac procedure, and I went over this morning. You already saw in the video that I said I was going to her house. I did some laundry, did some vacuuming. And I had intended to put up the Christmas tree, but unfortunately I ran out of time before I had to come back home and grab my son to take him to work. So that's on the agenda for probably 2 days from now. I have to go back out that way for a haircut. Yay, haircut! On Wednesday. So I think on my way back towards home, I'll stop and put the tree up and gather the mail and that kind of thing. They're projecting her hospital stay to be anywhere from 1 to 5 days. So, I mean, she is 90, so I'm thinking maybe the longer end of that, but I just don't expect her to be home anywhere before Wednesday. So, and then once she's home, my mom and I will be taking turns staying with her for 5 days following the procedure. So, anyway, good thoughts and prayers. Much appreciated there. As she recovers. So I actually got a lot of knitting done since the last time I put up a video. It was not, I didn't expect to, but Saturday night after my husband went to bed, I still wasn't feeling tired. So I said, well, I'm just going to stay up a while and knit. And a while turned into, I don't think I went to bed until almost 4 o'clock Sunday morning. I was just watching Vlogmas videos, catching up from the week. I think I'm following like 6 to 8 people, and you know, varying lengths of videos, but I mean, I probably the longest one is no longer than about 20 minutes, but still. So I sat down and just caught up on everybody's Vlogmas from the week and knit, and I just kept waiting to feel tired, and I never felt tired. So, but when it got to be 3:30, I figured I probably should call it a night. So between all that, knitting time and then the next morning, Sunday, so yesterday, my husband and I went to a local bar that is has recently started serving breakfast just on the weekends. And that's to offset some income that the owner may be losing due to the fact that our governor, who has been, a rock star throughout this whole pandemic, has decided that we need to go back on some tighter restrictions. So businesses have to close by 10 p.m. And for a bar, that's tough. Most people are just coming into the bar at 10 p.m. So anyway, the owner's getting creative with trying to generate some income, and we don't want her to go away. So we definitely want to support her. So Hubby and I jumped on the bike, and you probably will have seen. I don't know if I'll put it in prior to this or after, but whatever. I'm gonna. There will be a video of quickly of me on the back of the bike yesterday, freezing my tushy off. Thankfully, it's not very far from our house at all, and I survived. My motto in life is that you can survive anything for a short amount of time. So that includes. I don't know what the temperature was, but when you're on the back of a bike, it's 20 degrees colder, no matter which direction, which temperature the air is outside. So that wind was bitter. But anyway, I got inside. My nice friendly bartender gave me a naughty hot chocolate, which was hot chocolate with rum chata in it, and it was delightful and it warmed me up. Then she served me some delicious hash brown casserole, and my husband got a breakfast burrito, and that's generally what I like to get also, but I'll never turn down a good potato. Never. When it's offered. So I think next week we're gonna go back and I'll try the breakfast burritos then. But anyway, we sat around for a little while yesterday at the bar, and I got 23 rounds more knit on my sock. So I've got a lot more progress than what I had expected on that. But at 2 o'clock, I cut it off. I said, "Dude, it's time for Lady Vols to play." And so he came back and dropped me off, and then he went out for a nice extended ride with a friend of his, because at that point, I couldn't hang in with the cold. When I ride in cold weather with him, I put on my snowsuit and several layers underneath. I'll do it, but I've got to be prepared. So anyway, before I show you my knitting, I'll show you what I'm drinking. My sister gave me these glasses. Her in-laws had given her these wine glasses, and I think that she said they had like a dozen of them from the Biltmore. And I just like the shape of them. They're small, and they're nice in my hand. But I'm drinking Duplin Winery. They're based out of North Carolina. And this is the white sangria. And I've not honestly had anything from this winery that I did not like. I'd like to visit in person one day, when travel is a thing again. But until then, I'm glad that my local liquor store carries all the, well, not all the varieties, obviously, but a good amount of varieties of this wine. So, cheers. Okay, so as I said, I got about 20 something rounds done on the sock at the bar, and actually, from the last time you saw it, I had done more prior to that, I believe. It doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter. Who does it matter to? Anyway, here's my dang sock. Ooh. So the light is blowing out. Let's see if I tap the screen. Ah, that's not really helping. The light is blowing out this super bright neon yellow here, but the yellow is because, I mean, it's appropriate that it's blowing it out. You taught me everything I need to know, or you taught me everything I know about exterior illumination. So that, of course, was Clark speaking to his father. And probably once I finish the sock, I'll go ahead and read out what each color represents. Which reference to the in the movie. Words, oh my lord. But I'm getting a little nervous, honestly. I tried this on last night, and I don't know if I'm gonna make it through an entire 24 stripe repeat before I have to start the toe. I'll just wait and see. I mean, if I do, I do. If I don't, I don't. I mean, whatever. Okay, there's probably going to be just a tad bit of a disjoint in there. My phone just shut off recording for some crazy reason. I don't know. Thought he would test me today, I suppose. Okay, so I was saying that I don't know that I'm going to get through an entire color repeat, but that's okay. My foot is 9 inches in length, I believe, but anyway, I might. I'm in color. You know what? Take that back. I probably will because I've only got one, two, three, four colors before I'm back to the beginning. Yeah, I think I most definitely should hit that. I am a ladies six, US six. So I think, like I said, I think my foot's about a 9 inch length, something like that. Whatever. It's just a freaking sock, but it would be nice if I could get through the full color repeat. So that is that. So really, I'm gonna have, a first sock finished much sooner than I had expected. So that's cool. Speaking of socks, today I am wearing my 20 my socks that I knit for Christmas this year. I've never had designated Christmas socks, so I used the Mint Rain hand dyed yarns Grinch colorway to knit socks for myself, specifically to wear in December this year. I started those back in July, and because Dana and I had talked about doing kind of a knit along between the two of us, and I set an alarm. We started on July 1st, or that was the projected start date, and she kicked my butt. She also used her Kirby Wirby 2019 Advent skein and made herself some really cute shorties, but I wanted mine to specifically scream Christmas, so that's why I went with the Grinch colorway. They are black, red, and green. Okay, so that's what I knit yesterday when I was out with hubby. Saturday night, when I was catching up on all the Vlogmas videos with all you wonderful people out there, which thank you so much for putting up videos if you are one putting up videos, because it's nice to visit with people, briefly and just get a peek behind the curtain of their lives and know that we're all in this together. We're all just doing the best we can, right? So anyway, I was just really enjoying knitting on this baby Sophisticate as I was watching these videos, and I think because I decided to go with striping. I just couldn't bring myself to stop. And once I get going and, the end is in sight, I don't want to stop. I'm sure you can all relate. So, this is my creepy newborn doll. One year for Christmas, there are three children in my family, and my brother and sister and I all got one of these dolls. And somehow or another, this is the boy doll because they were anatomically correct in 1988. 89, I don't remember for sure, but this is the boy doll, and he's the only surviving one of the three of them, probably because my brother didn't want anything to do with him that I remember. Anyway, I'm glad to have him because he is definitely my model for anything newborn sized. So this is what I've got going on here. It's gonna get some sleeves and a shawl collar, and then it will be finished. Actually, that is not true. It'll get some buttons sewn on it as well. But I'm thrilled so far with how this came out, and I can't wait to get the set done. So yay! Now, on to Advent, I suppose, because nothing else I got to talk about. Okay, so yesterday's baggie is number six, and it is here. And oh, there's an extra. Oh, look at this sweet little don't know how well that's showing. It's a stitch marker, and it's an angel. Oh, it's so cute. Okay. There's that. And the colorway for day six is Candy Cane. It's really pretty. Yeah, it's pinks, and there's a deep red stripe in there, but it's very pretty. Okay, Candy Cane. I didn't bring over the previous day's games, but I'm sure it's going to tie in nicely because so far Melissa's done a really nice job with making sure that that's the case. And then here's day 7. And this is Peppermint Puff. I'm not really a big fan of peppermint, but you know, for some reason peppermint puffs don't count, and they are delicious to me. So these are going to be really nice together. Yeah. Good stuff. I'm loving the theme of this Advent set as well. Who doesn't love candy? I mean, I don't know. Maybe there are some people out there, but I'm not one of them people. Okay. So I don't think there was anything else as I'm looking here. Boy, I got a mess. I went up into the attic a little while ago and pulled down some Christmas lights. I figured this week where there's no rain in the forecast, until I think possibly on Sunday. So, I figure while it was nice, I mean, it's going to be cold. It's going to be in the 40s and 50s, but at least I can get outside and maybe hang some Christmas lights. Our house, the roof is not very tall, so our 6-foot ladder is adequate for me to get up there and hang lights. And we've got some icicle lights. My husband went crazy a few years ago and went to the Walmart and like blew it out with all these light purchases. And I think he put them up that 1 year, and then every year since, like, he just is not interested. So if I want them up, I'm going to put them up myself. Currently, I've got my orange lights up because every Saturday when the Vols play, I turn them lights on. Think of it as a good luck omen, if you will, although it hasn't really been very lucky. But I'm a diehard fan. I'm not going anywhere. So I think, you know, since this season started on September the 19th, I think my neighbors didn't know what to do with me. Because they are orange lights, I think they probably assumed they were Halloween lights. But now, you know, when I burn them on Saturday, December the 5th, they probably maybe just assumed that I'm just that nutty woman who can't be bothered to take her lights down. Which, I mean, I don't really, I'm not bothered by what other people think of me, so whatever. But all that to say, that's my plan for maybe this afternoon, possibly tomorrow. And other than that, I don't know. We'll see what I get up to. But I thank you for joining me today, and I hope that you have enjoyed sitting and taking a few minutes for yourself, and that you are having a very good beginning to December as well. So I'll talk to you in 2 days. Bye, y'all.